Hey, Mom. Me home.
And now it's time for another episode of Hey, Mom, with the hardest working West Indian family, the Headleys.
Hey, Norman, how many times I got to tell you not to put your uniforms on my good sofa?
Don't yell at me, woman. I drop my uniform wherever I want. I wear 15 jobs. I don't have time for your foolishness. When I come home, I'm tired, damn it.
Listen, you think you're the only one work hard? I got 9 jobs myself, you know. But is I have to do all the cooking and the cleaning and the washing around here, not to mention the welding.
Well, combined, that's only 12 jobs, lazy woman.
What do you think it is, this
hour? Hey, man. Speaking of lazy, here's the laziest Eddie had ever lived. Young Billy Vanilli Rasta Boy. Aren't you supposed to be working at the hotel now?
No, because I just got fired from there.
What happened?
Oh, you got fired?
I don't carry no Yankee man's bag. Plus, me have 4 perfectly good jobs left.
Full job. Let me tell you something, young Rasta boy. When I was your age, I was a maintenance man, a carpenter, a cab driver, a cook, a hospital orderly, a security guard, a tour guide, a fish cleaner, and an Amway distributor, all in the same day. I didn't even have time to almost make you, boy.
But, Pop, me in 10 bands now. Me don't have even a little bit of time for myself now.
10 bands. And full job. That's 14 things. That's not as bad as I thought, boy. Come here, you chip off the old banana boat. Me proud of you, boy. You hear that, you lazy layabouts? My boy got 14 jobs.
Hey, man.
Well, if it ain't table napkin turn tablecloth. What you doing home right now?
Daddy, leave me alone. I have a date with my new boyfriend.
What? Really now? Tell us about this new fella.
Well, him name is Danny. Him American, him very funny, and I think I love he.
And what else? What do Daddy want to hear?
Well, him very successful, you know. Him make over $100,000 a year. Mama gonna be rich.
$100,000?
How many jobs he got to make $100,000?
Only one? He's a doctor?
One job! One job! The good deed, the boy with one job!
I hear it.
That's all you ever talk about, work, work, work. What about love? Look at the two of you, you're tired and you're bogged out all the time. Why don't you go and take a vacation?
Me on vacation now from 13 jobs.
But Papa, how can I think about working when I am in love? It's just like when you and Mama just met, remember?
I never loved your mother. I married your mother because she had 6 jobs.
To that nice Korean boy you was dating. He had 100 jobs.
Him dead now. Him dropped dead at a job interview.
Well, that means 100 job opening.
100 job opening? Someone get my newspaper, don't say.
I don't know why I tell you stupid people anything. I'm in love, and that's the most important thing. You should also be on my side.
Hey,
anyway.
You really shut up in there. It's not joking.
Yeah, shut the hell up in there. Godfrey Henley be quacking your own house. If I didn't have to go to work, if I had a time, I'd come whoop your ass right now. Oh, no. Oh, my God. Look at the time. Oh, hey, man. I gotta go to work.
Join us again soon for Hey, Man with the Headleys. You can't tell if they're happy or mad. They're just working.
Oh, I just love these old horror movies, don't you?
Yeah. I must have at least seen them some 50 times.
Well, which one do you like
better? We at Cineglobe Theaters know that nothing is more annoying than having to listen to a movie while people in the theater are talking. That's why we turn down the volume on our movies so that you can really hear yourselves talking.
Don't go in there.
Don't open that door, stupid. Ooh, don't take off that hood now.
He's going to turn to the fly right now. Watch.
He's a fly.
Please be quiet. I'm just trying to watch the film.
Oh, what is this guy?
Come on, you're up and you're out of here. Come on.
Cineglobe Theater. Admission may be reduced if no movie is showing.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Roger Spitman for the Wild World of Sports. And welcome to the final round of the 10th Annual Sweethearts Bodybuilding Competition here in beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. It's the greased up pose portion of the show. The action has been pretty fierce here, and here comes our first competitor. She's Sarah Sunkiss from Salamander, California. This is her first finals. Not a lot of muscle mass and still quite feminine. And quite frankly, I don't like that, and neither do the judges. She's going to have a tough time here today. Next is Carla Meals. She's 5'7", 140 pounds from Beaverton, Wisconsin. Pretty good definition. But she's having trouble getting rid of those darn breasts. And that's going to come against her. I mean, look at them. They just won't go away. And finally, the competitor everyone's been waiting to see. You can feel the anticipation. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Of course, she's the only woman on the circuit who goes to the bathroom standing up. Oh, yeah. She is working it tonight. She is in top. Oh, but there she goes. Showing her feminine side with the perfect obstetric push. It's her ode to the mystery of motherhood. Oh, baby. She is hard as a rock. Magnificent. After a performance like that, can there be any doubt? Ladies and gentlemen, the judges have come to a decision. And the winner is Miss Vera DeMilo. Congratulations on a great victory for you, princess. Now, the reports are that you have used steroids. Do you care to comment on that, little lady?
Yes, I would, Roger. I don't know who's starting those rumors, but I do know that there are a lot of jealous people out there who aren't willing to do the work it takes to look like this. Let's face it, women see me, they want to be me.
Well said. Well said. Could you just tell me one more thing then, Vera?
Sure.
I gotta ask you this. What is that bulge in front of your trousers?
Well, now, a girl's gotta have her little secrets. That's where I keep my chewing tobacco.
And I can see that you still have that wonderfully feminine sense of humor.
Oh, this is my boyfriend and trainer, Bart.
And what a lucky man.
Oh, baby. Look at her. Isn't she beautiful? Oh, oh.
Proudly presents a new do-it-yourself at-home home improvement show. My name is Anton, and this is my house, slash bathroom slash kitchen slash backyard slash library. Oh, I forgot we're on TV. Let me fix my makeup. Now, we're gonna need a little bit of work light, so let's go to a convenient power source. Remember, safety lasts when you ain't got no money. Now, today we're gonna add on a new room, but I have to make sure that I got the proper tools. This is the drill, my hammer, my measuring tape, oh, that's the extension cord. Let's just use the rope for now. I need my screwdriver. I need another one. Now let's get started, shall we? Now, in order to add on this new room, we're gonna have to make a new doorway. So what do? We mark it. With an X. And then we cut the hole. Now, in order to bond this, we're going to have to use an all-natural adhesive. Your children don't try this at home. We just put that there, and when this dries, it'll be crazy like crazy glue. Now, our new guest wing is almost complete. But not yet. We need to install the plumbing. I'll go get the bathroom. Toilet paper in there. So now when company come over, they don't have to steal your bathroom. Well, that's the show for today. Join me next week when I'll be showing you how to make a jacuzzi out of a garbage can. This is Anton for This Old Box saying, I still have something of a...
Laquita, I'm home.
Hey, sweetheart. That's my baby. I'm right in the middle of stuff, painting my nails.
Nails? What about dinner?
I got some pig feet steaming on the stove.
Pig feet? Ay, ay, ay. My mother told me never to marry a crazy redhead from Compton.
Well, you did.
I told you last week I'm having a very important producer over for dinner, Armand and I.
Producer? Producer? Ricky, sit down. Ricky, look, you think he might be interested in a female rapper? My name's Laquita.
Laquita! Let me explain something to you.
What you gonna explain to me?
Don't make fun of my language.
You ain't got no language.
Laquita, I am gonna tell you something for the 1,000th time. I don't want any more of your hair-brand scams to get into your business.
But Ricky, come on, man. I could be the next Queen Latifah.
No, but. Now, go on in there and set the table.
Shoot.
I'll go to the Chinese restaurant downstairs and get something a little more fit for human consumption. And don't forget, the cable man is coming. He'll be here any minute.
What you say?
Hi, Laquita, it's me.
Sit down. Yo, check this out. Ricky's gonna have a big-time producer coming over here.
Tonight. A producer?
Producer. So I figured we could do our salt and pepper routine.
Oh, Laquita, I don't know. Well,
but that's him. That's him. Just follow along, right? Just bust the move, whatever
well,
I do.
Right, honey.
Is this the Mercado residence?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, I'm looking for Mr. Mercado. I'm from Continental Television.
Well, we were expecting you. Come on in. Come on in. Have a seat.
Okay.
Have a seat.
Oh, okay.
Ethel, give the nice man something to drink.
Oh,
some Ripple. On the rocks. You want a massage, a leg massage?
Yeah, sure, I guess.
Here you are. Would you like something to eat?
Thank you, yeah. Okay.
Do you like music?
Well, I guess so. I mean, who doesn't?
Yeah. Well, peep this out. One, two, one, two. What we gonna do? My name's Laquita. I tell you, see, I'm the kind of girl to be on TV. Over here, on my right, with the girl. She's a girl, she's a pen, she's a human being. I say, what?
Oh, oh. That was great. I mean, you two really should be on TV.
Yes!
Now, just listen. I got a service contract right here.
Well, let me put my John Hancock on.
Wait a minute. Not so fast. Nothing gets signed until I take care of the physical connection.
What?
You know, I have to plug my cable into the box.
Oh, wait, I don't know.
Well, this is standard procedure. It'll only take about 5 minutes. Maybe a little longer. This is my 12th one today.
12?
Yeah, one lady I saw this morning took almost 2 hours. Mm-hmm. The poor woman couldn't remember where her box was. And when we finally found it, it was all rusted shut. I had to use a crowbar.
Oh, my God.
Laquita, I don't know about this.
Come on. Just think about it. We're talking the big time here. We could be on Showtime at the Apollo and the Byron Allen Show.
Byron Allen!
Where do you want to do it, ladies?
We ain't no freaks. In the bedroom, of course.
No problem. You know, I got more than 100 feet of cable.
Oh. He ain't got no 100 feet of cable.
Look, I just run it up the side of the building and right through the window.
Oh, no. Please. This is our big chance. Please, Ethel, please.
Well,
come on. You know Fred ain't throwing down in the bedroom anyway.
All right, sir, you can do me first and then my friend.
Are you kidding? I can get a splitter and turn you both on.
We can do it one at a time, if you don't mind.
Okay, fine with me. Let's get it over with.
Well, aren't you going to leave that here?
Ah, the right tool for the right job.
Oh. Well, if you say so.
Hey, lady, what are you doing?
Ricky!
Hi, honey. This is that producer I told you about.
Producer? But if that's the producer, then who?
Yeah. You let the cable man in?
Nope. Ethel did.
Ethel? What happened?
I just got free cable for the whole.
From Hollywood, it's the most non-threatening black men on television, the Brothers Brothers.
Tom.
My brother's a brother, and so am I, for so it appears to the casual eye. The networks want blacks, but they don't want them real, so Oreos like us get a hell of a deal. So it's hi-ho, to prime time we go, with the hey you jive turkey, and what do you say, bro? Whiter than snow. We're brothers who are brothers, and we have our own show.
Hey, Tom.
Yes, Tom?
Wait, how can we both be named Tom?
Easy. We're named after our uncle. Oh, boy. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Spike.
Spike who?
Hope it's not Spike Lee, that little troublemaker.
What's his problem? Oh.
So it's hidey-ho, as I pick out my fro. We all play the same parts, whatever the show. The guys are all pimps, and each chick is a hoe. If we just sell out, we'll be rolling in dough.
Say, Tom.
Yes, Tom?
Did you know Mother was coming to live with us?
Uh-oh, there goes the neighborhood.
Bill Cosby's a doctor with a lawyer for a wife. As black folks all know, it's the average life. A six-bedroom house and a really cute pup. His kids don't do drugs and they don't get knocked up.
Tom?
Yes, Tom?
What's black and white all over?
Us!
With a hidey-ho and a what's happening do. Show you our real selves would only be rude. It's a whole different world till our ratings get low. We're brothers who are brothers, and we have our own show. We're brothers who are brothers, and we have our own show.
Brothers Brothers Comedy Hour is brought to you by Whiteout. If you can't see it, you can pretend it doesn't exist.
This month on HBO, she's loud, she's ugly, she wears an overcoat, and she's a screaming success. She's Samantha Kinison.
Yeah, it's great to be here tonight. Guess you can tell it's my anniversary. That's right. I've been married for 5 years. To a man! I try not to be bitter about it, though. I guess I just pictured marriage as being somewhat different, you know? I guess I just pictured something other than some lazy slob laying around reading Playboys and drinking Black Label. Morning, honey. Sure wish I could stick around waiting on you having foot your all day, but one of us has got to earn a living. I tell you, maybe next time I'll consider marrying a little higher up on the food chain, like maybe an amoeba or something. I'm not bitter, though. I love man. I have always loved man. I'll never forget the first time I fell in love. I was about 18 years old, you know. I'll never forget it. I was just waiting for the right man to come and sweep me right off my feet. Just sweep me off my feet. Not use me like a ride at Disney World! But I still remember the first one. That's right. Wrote a little song about him. He looks something like you, sir, Mr. Smooth down there in the front row. How you doing? I bet you've been in love, sir. I bet you've taken some young lady under your arm, sir. I bet you told her that you loved her and she believed you. Well, I'd like to sing a song to you right now that I wrote for my honey lamb, and it goes something like this. You bastard! You broke my heart! You said you loved me, you lying son of a bitch! You lame ass! I never felt your... I never...
never failed you!
You'll laugh, you'll gasp, you'll burn in hell! Samantha Kinison, this month on HBO.
I have a surprise for you.
Yeah!
Hold me the crown.
Yeah! Hold me the crown. Hold me the crown. Hold me the crown. Hold me the crown.
Hold me. Hold me. Hold me. Hold me. Hold me. Hold me. Hold me.
All right, kids, I'm Homie the Clown. Y'all ready to have some fun?
Yeah!
All right, what y'all want me to do first?
Ooh. Oh, Homie. Do a silly clown dance for us.
Oh. Yeah!
Yeah, degrading myself, huh? I don't think so. Homie, don't play that. Fall down, bust my skull open, have my blood and brains ooze out on the carpet so you can get a couple of cheap laughs, huh? I don't think so. Homie, don't play that. What else?
Bing! Hey, hey! Can we smash a cream pie in your face like you're doing the clowns and stuff?
Yeah!
I think you got it backwards, son. Now, how do you feel about yourself?
Totally dissed, homie.
That's why homie don't play that. All right, how about a magic trick?
Yeah!
Who got a dollar?
I do, homie. Here you go, homie.
All right, I fold it once.
Ooh.
Twice.
Ah.
Now it's gone. Ta-da! Kids, homie may be a clown, but he don't make a fool out of himself.
Why you become a clown, dear?
I guess it's because I got so much love to give. And it's part of my prison work release program. So I got about 5 more years of this clown crap. Cartoon time! Y'all pay special attention because this one has a certain message to it.
Ooh.
Once upon a time, Homie the Clown went to a fancy white restaurant. Shea Whitey was the name. As always, Homie gets hassled by the man. He tells him that a tie is required in order to eat in this establishment. So Homie says, man, get them damn ties out of my face or I'll kick your ass. But unfortunately, Monsieur Snowflake didn't quite hear Homie correctly. So Homie had no choice but to keep his word. The end. So what have we learned, if nothing else, children?
Homie don't play that!
Right, now let's sing the Homie the Clown song.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Repeat after me. Homie the Clown.
Homie the Clown.
Don't mess around.
Don't mess around.
Even though the man.
Even though the man.
Try to keep him down.
Try to keep him down.
One day, homie will break all the chains, then he'll fly away. But until that day, homie, don't play. I said, repeat after me. Very good. That made homie smile after all. birthday, kid.